This message is to encourage believers who speak in tongues and also to give revelation and activation of this wonderful gift of God that He has given to believers. I will also address some misunderstandings people have regarding speaking in tongues. There are a number of phrases we see when we talk about prayer that has to do with the influence and power of the Holy Spirit. These phrases are speaking in tongues, praying in the Holy Spirit, praying with the Spirit, singing with the Spirit, praying in an unknown tongue, praying in other tongues. Jude 1 verse 20 to 21 says, "But you, beloved, building yourselves up on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit, keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life." Praying in the Holy Spirit is praying by the influence of the Spirit, in the harmony of the Spirit, and in the power of the Spirit. You see, when you pray in your flesh, you may pray from your emotions. God doesn't respond to emotions. He responds to faith. Praying in the Holy Spirit is building up yourself in your most holy faith. Praying with your understanding could lead to unbelief, but praying in the Spirit will build your faith to receive answers to your prayer. When you believe in Jesus, you become one spirit with Him. 1 Corinthians 6 verse 17 says, "But he who is joined to the Lord is one spirit with Him." Praying in the Spirit is praying according to the will of God. Prayer is not what connects us to the Lord. We are already joined to the Lord by faith. Romans 8 verse 26. "In the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Spirit Himself intercedes for us through wordless groans." Many people struggle to pray because they are doing it in the flesh. You see, the human being is a tripartite being made of the body, soul, and spirit. The body comprises of the five senses. The soul comprises of the mind, feelings, and emotions. The spirit of a man is the candle of the Lord. It is that part of the man that connects with God. It is the spirit of man that becomes one spirit with the Lord. Some believers get caught up with physical religious gestures, like what should be my posture at the place of prayer. Should I kneel or should I stand or should I lie down? What is necessary is praying in harmony, will, and power of the Holy Spirit. Pray in tongues, put us in the realms of the supernatural, where our will aligns with the will of God. When we pray in tongues, we are putting our desires in line with the desires of the Holy Spirit. 1 Corinthians 2 verse 9 to 10 says, "But as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love Him. But God has revealed them to us through His Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God." The Spirit reveals the will of God for us so that we can pray correctly. It is only through praying in the Spirit you get to know it. 1 Corinthians 14 verse 1 says, "Pursue love and desire spiritual gifts, but especially that you may prophesy." God wants you to desire spiritual gifts. He wants you to desire the gift of speaking in tongues. God is saying the pursuit of love and the desire for spiritual gifts should go together. You should also desire especially to prophesy. 1 Corinthians 14 verse 2 says, "If you have the ability to speak in tongues, you will be talking only to God, since people won't be able to understand you. You'll be speaking by the power of the Spirit, but it will all be mysterious." Praying in tongues is speaking only to God. Tongues is prayer that only God understands because it is a language of the Spirit. and God is a spirit. God understands all mysteries. People don't necessarily have to understand it, since it is for God only. If you want men to understand, it will no more be called speaking in tongues. It will be called prophesying. On the other hand, the one who prophesies speaks to people for their upbuilding and encouragement and consolation. 1 Corinthians 14 verse 3. Prophecy is about speaking plain words that men can understand. But tongues is speaking mysteries to God that only He can understand. A person who speaks in tongues is strengthened personally. But he who speaks a word of prophecy strengthens the entire church. 1 Corinthians 14 verse 4. Tongues is a personal language. It is a language that the Holy Spirit communicates with the human spirit. Tongues strengthen the person speaking it, but prophecy strengthens the church. In a public gathering, if you are making a prayer that you want someone to understand and to say amen, then you prophesy. But if it is a prayer between only you and God, then you speak in tongues. Tongues will strengthen your faith. Tongues build up your faith, but prophecy builds up the faith of the whole church. Now, tongues can build up the whole church if it is interpreted. Some people now come with the lie that Apostle Paul discouraged the speaking of tongues. We will look at that in today's teaching. 1 Corinthians 14 verse 5 says, I wish you all spoke with tongues, but even more that you prophesied. For he who prophesies is greater than he who speaks with tongues, unless indeed he interprets, that the church may receive edification. God wishes that all believers spoke in tongues. Even though prophecy has a greater place than speaking in tongues, God didn't rule out the fact that all men should speak in tongues. Speaking in tongues is still good with interpretations. Speaking in tongues without interpretation is a personal supplication to God. Speaking in tongues without interpretation strengthens the individual speaking in tongues. Apostle Paul never said we should not speak in tongues. Apostle Paul explains further in 1 Corinthians 14 verse 6. Dear brothers and sisters, if I come to you speaking in an unknown language, how would that help you? But if I bring you a revelation, or some special knowledge, or prophecy, or teaching, that would be helpful. Speaking in tongues is going to God and not going to the brethren. If you stand before the brethren to edify, exalt, and comfort, you don't speak in tongues, but you prophesy. What I am doing now is that I am teaching the word of God and encouraging your faith. So I am prophesying. I am not speaking in tongues. I am bringing to you knowledge and revelation about speaking in tongues. How do I speak in tongues? The Bible gives us the answer in Acts 2 verse 4. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Tongues are utterances from the Spirit of God. The second lie I want to confront is tongues are formed by men. Tongues are not formed by men. Neither is the combination of many languages learned. Tongues is a language you speak as the Spirit gives you utterance. It is not just some gibberish that is carefully created from the human mind. Tongues is a spiritual language. The third lie about tongues I want to expose is tongues are supposed to be understood. 1 Corinthians 14 verse 14 says, For if I pray in tongues, my spirit is praying, but I don't understand what I'm saying. You don't need to understand the tongues you are speaking. If the Holy Spirit brings it to your understanding, glory be to God. But if you don't understand it, it doesn't diminish the power of your prayer. The fourth lie about tongues, you will open yourself up to demons if you pray in tongues. It is a blatant lie. If you know who you are in Christ Jesus, demons are nothing. The faith in speaking in tongues can defeat the devil. The power of tongues casts out devils. Speaking in tongues may look foolish to those who don't believe in tongues. Since tongues is a language of the Holy Spirit, it will look foolish to the natural man. But for those of us who believe and are baptized in the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues, we know it is very powerful. If you want to pray when you don't know what to pray in your understanding, you need the infilling of the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues. Apostle Paul said, "I thank God that I speak in tongues more than any of you." 1 Corinthians 14 verse 18. But in a church meeting, I would rather speak 5 understandable words to help others than 10,000 words in an unknown tongue. What Apostle Paul is saying is that praying in your understanding can give you few words, but praying in tongues has the ability to give you about 10,000 words. Tongues help you to pray fervently, persistently, and for hours. There are limitations in the language of men, but the language of the Spirit has no limitations. I pray for you that may you be filled with the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues. In Jesus' name, amen.